Welcome to the Past, Present, and Future broadcast. I'm Julia DePalma.
And I'm Juliana Distante, and we are your peer health educators and hosts for this presentation. We would like to introduce our theme, which will be past, present, and future, focusing on where we were, where we are, and where we plan to go.
As the presentation progresses, stay tuned to see exciting giveaways and prizes.
We would like to say a few quick thank yous before we begin. Thank you, Sebastian Little, for your presentation. Thank you, Coach Lee. Thank you, Mr. Salamini. Thank you, Ms. Trafone. And thank you to administration, and most importantly, our peer health class. Now it's time to reflect when COVID-19 first uprailed our lives.
This timeline shows photos and videos up until this past semester.
Enjoy and reminisce with us.
Giving up and giving in, tell me, in this house of mine, nothing ever comes without a consequence or cost, tell me, will the stars align, will heaven step in, will it save us from our sin, will it, cause this house of mine stands strong, that's the price you pay.
Yeah.
what's happening. Looking through the glass, find the wrong within the past, knowing we are the youth. Cut it till it bleeds out of wood without the peace, facing a bit of the truth, the truth. That's the price you pay.
CHS, and welcome to the most exciting part of today's video. At least Connor and I think so. We will be with you a number of times throughout this video to share some questions with you. And with questions come really amazing prizes. We're not lying. They're good. If you check your email, you will see a Google form has been shared with you by the Peer Health Educators, which you will use to answer all of today's questions. Please make sure to submit your completed Google form by 2 o'clock today. Winners will be notified tomorrow via email. And this brings us in to our first prize question. While there were many changes, high risk versus low risk, return to play measures, no state tournaments, and the odd realignment of the SEC's division, along with the precautions, practice cohorts, contact tracing, and limited or no spectators, the SEC had a successful fall sports season. Principals, athletic directors, coaches, and support staff worked together despite unique daily challenges for the betterment of students and the league. Student athletes showed leadership, diligence, and perseverance to make the best of their athletic experience. Question number one. How many Cheshire High School fall sports teams made it to the SEC tournament championship game?
Hello, and welcome to the Peer Health-sponsored quarantine-friendly activities. My name is Lucy Helene, and I will be sharing some of these activities with you. We hope you enjoy participating and even consider sending in a picture to the Peer Health Instagram, which is at @CHS_PeerHealth, for a chance to be featured with you and your friends. Now on to our top 10 list. At item number 10, we have online shopping. We especially recommend supporting small businesses during these challenging times. Number 9, make a puzzle, a personal favorite of mine throughout quarantine. Number 8, binge a Netflix series. You can select a documentary, a TV show, movies, plenty of choices as a distraction. Number 7, play a board game. You could do this with your friends and or family as a way to stay entertained. Number 6, get takeout from your favorite restaurant. We have plenty of options here in Cheshire to choose from, and again, you'll be supporting businesses in your community. Number 5, participate in a birthday parade. It's always great to make someone's day during quarantine and celebrate them a little bit. Number 4, cook a meal for your family. It's a great way to spend time with your loved ones and learn a new task. Number 3, go to the beach. You could go swimming over the summer, but now you could just go watch the sunset and enjoy the outdoors. Number 2, go hiking with friends. You may think because it's cold, we can't really do that anymore, but you can always layer up and get some fresh air. And finally, number 1, enjoy a picnic in the park. Again, getting outside is so important, and that could be a safe way to see some friends. Thanks for watching, and we hope you enjoyed these top 10 quarantine-friendly activities.
What is your favorite meal at CHS?
Ooh, probably chicken patty.
What are your hopes for 2021?
Just for everything to get back to normal.
Who is the best athlete at CHS?
Chisholm.
What are your hopes for 2021?
Hope to have a happy and safe and healthy 2021. Hopefully we get some football, hopefully we get some sports back, and we're able to go back to normalcy.
What are your hopes for 2021?
To be able to freely hang out with my friends before I go off to college.
So, Mr. Ram, you've bulked up quite a bit since the last time I met you. Can you tell us how? Oh, that's interesting. How are you feeling for this upcoming year for the senior class? Nice. That's a good answer right there. My friend Lovelace, he wanted to get a picture with you. Is that okay? All right. Word. It's going on my wall. Thank you.
The Cheshire Community Food Pantry is located on Sandbank Road. Their mission statement is, "We are a community organization that provides food and situations for all eligible individuals and families in need, regardless of their race, color, religion, national origin, age, sex, or disability. Free will donations come from the general Cheshire community. We accomplish equitable distribution through the generous giving of time and labor by an organized team of compassionate volunteers. Each week, eligible families shop at the food pantry. Clients are able to choose the items that best fit their family and needs. Majority of food is donated by our own community. This year, Cheshire High School students participated in a townwide food drive ran by Peer Health and the National Honor Society. This brings us into our second question. How many pounds of food were collected during the 2020 CHS food drive?
Welcome back. Now to feature Peer Health. Here are a few of our projects that Peer Health is sponsoring. The Lunch Mentoring Program, Wellness Wednesdays at CHS, the Elementary School Kindness Initiative, the Elementary School Leadership Conference, the Middle School Leadership Conference, and of course, the High School Leadership Conference.
Follow us on the Peer Health Instagram at @CHS_PeerHealth to keep up with us. Enjoy a sneak peek at our projects with these few videos.
Hi, my name is Sophia and my friends and I are participating in the Great Kindness Challenge this month. Come with me and watch us complete our challenges.
Hey, Nani!
Hi, hi, how are you?
I'm good. I just wanted to call you because I miss you and I love you.
Oh, thank you, honey.
Oh, hey. I love that sweatshirt.
Oh, thank you so much.
Oh, after you. Thanks, man.
Now to feature the school's top news source, The Rampage. The Rampage has several platforms including Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and TikTok to keep updated. Through the provided video, you can see a walkthrough of the entire website.
Stay updated on current news at your school and around the world while keeping an eye out for the winter print edition in the month of February as well. Now enjoy a sponsored segment from The Rampage.
Hello, and welcome to Good News sponsored by The Rampage. I'm Juliana DeSante, and I'm going to be walking you through some good news. Now for good news at CHS and in the community. The Peer Health Class and National Honor Society sponsored a food drive and donated 5,063 pounds of food to the local food pantry. Best Buddies has sponsored two drive-thrus since the beginning of the year in the first semester. The first was a Halloween drive-thru and the second was a holiday drive-thru. Within that drive-thru, they sponsored a book drive for the local Reread Bookstore in partnership with National English Honor Society. The spring musical Little Women has started rehearsals and begins preparing for the show. The winter sports season was given the thumbs up to start practices on January 19th, and the competition season for approved sports will start February 8th. NHS is sponsoring Cards Against Corona for frontline workers to show their appreciation. National English Honor Society is writing pen pals with Chapman sixth graders. Now for national politics and policy. Kamala Harris becomes the United States' first female, first Black, and first Asian American vice president. Joe Biden signed sweeping executive order fighting anti-LGBTQ plus discrimination. Amazon launches $2 billion funding to make 20,000 affordable homes for working families. The world's first biomarker test can predict depression and bipolar disorder. Yelp will now tell you if a business is following COVID-19 protocols. Robert Saleh is set to become the NFL's first Muslim head coach, and Sarah Thomas will be the first female to referee an NFL game. Ivory Coast designates first ever marine sanctuary. An experimental Alzheimer's drug delivers promising results in phase 2 trial. Now for some environmental news. A new initiative is paying farmers to combat Amazon deforestation. Gothenburg, Sweden develops world's first zero emission zone. Morocco aims for 50% renewable energy by 2030. Joe Biden halts Keystone XL pipeline construction. Joe Biden has re-entered the U.S. into the Paris Agreement. Colorado approves $110 million transportation electrification plan. Germany used more renewables than fossil fuels in 2020 for the first time ever. Four major Asian nations cancel 80% of planned coal power projects. And Vermont has passed a law enforcing every household to compost. Thank you for watching the Rampage sponsored segment of Good News.
What are your hopes for 2021?
Be better than 2020.
I mean, I can't help but agree with that.
If you were to be a superhero and you had one superpower, what would it be and why?
I think I would have to pick flying.
Expecting something a little bit cooler.
I know, it's so on the spot. I don't know. Flying's cool, and yeah, that's what I'd pick.
What is something you're looking forward to in 2021?
Oh, geez. Getting back to normal, hopefully.
That's a good answer. If you had to pick one spice, like from anything, saffron, paprika, all that, you know, what would it be?
Salt.
because salt brings out the flavor of every single food. Even though there is an unhealthy component to it, it enhances the flavor of everything. So you can limit the amount, but it's the most important spice in the kitchen.
So if you were a superhero, right? You have one superpower.
Yep.
What would it be and why?
I think my superpower would be to read people's minds. Because I think if you know what people are thinking, you can solve a lot of problems because you understand what they're going through.
How do you feel having the best hair out of the entire CHS faculty?
It makes me feel good. I mean, I'm not jealous about anyone else, but I don't think anybody really has to feel jealous about me.
I mean, I think they do.
Do you think they're jealous of me?
I mean, look at the hair.
Oh.
Every winter, the CHS community sponsors the annual Winterfest. This event brings together CHS students, teachers, administrators, and people from throughout our community and focuses on spreading holiday cheer. Despite the many challenges we have faced since the beginning of the school year, the CHS community found a way to spread some holiday cheer. During December, Cheshire High School held the Holiday Drive-In, which was a day that focused on giving the most to kids even during this different and difficult holiday season. Our third question is, what Cheshire High School organization sponsored the 2020 Holiday Drive-Thru?
This has been a truly unique and unforgettable final year for our seniors, to say the least.
We hope this tribute from our caring teachers for our seniors lifts your spirits for the remainder of the year.
What is something you like about the class of 2021?
I love the fact that the class of 2021 is resilient. You guys have hung in there at one of the worst times, and everybody has stayed positive. I think the class of 2021 is one of the best.
Thank you.
They're definitely a resilient group. Certainly a class that's gone through things their junior and senior year that no class ever has before. And those are, you know, really two of the most important kind of formative years of their, you know, of their educational career, and they've met challenges and unprecedented challenges and just handled it all in an impressive way. You know, from what I've observed, they've met those challenges, you know, to the best that we could hope for.
Trying to appreciate the seniors a little bit, what is something good you have to say about the class of 2021?
I love the class of 2021. You guys are like my little babies, and you're just empathetic and nice and compassionate, and you have a sense of humor, and you know.
Thank you. What is your favorite part about the class of 2021?
I think it's their resilience. Everything that they've been through since 2020, everything that was canceled in the spring, everything that was canceled in the fall, and how they've shown up for everything that we've asked them to do and more, that has been really memorable about that class, in your class.
What would be your favorite thing about the class of 2021?
That they came through this bolder, wiser, stronger. This, I mean, the pandemic. They came through stronger, wiser, and better. And I hope they continue to be as strong when they move on into whatever they decide to do, whether it's college, the military, or employment.
If you had to name your favorite part about, like, the class of 2021, what would your favorite part about a class be?
I have to say, you are definitely the most resilient group. You've had a lot of impediments to your senior year, and you've still made it work. So whether it's the athletes, like bringing the energy every day, or the students just in class, being engaged, whether virtually or in person, you guys make it work. I have to say, students have complained the least, and probably because of the leadership of the class of 2021.
All right, thank you.
The CHS Drama Department has faced many challenges this year, but despite this, they have persevered and truly shown the meaning of The Show Must Go On. In the fall, the Drama Department put on a COVID-friendly production of Twelfth Night. Now, the department is getting ready and rehearsing the spring musical. Despite the fact that we won't be able to see it live, we know it is going to be amazing when they perform it virtually this spring. Question 4. What is the name of the 2021 Cheshire High School Spring Musical?
First word, Cole Feinauer, of the 2021 Spelling Bee. Plankton.
Plankton. P-L-A-N-K-T-O-N.
Plankton. Magnificent. Nick DiDemizio. Garage.
Garage. G-A-R-A-G-E. Garage.
Thank you.
Cole Feinauer, conditioner.
Conditioner. C-O-N-T.
No. Now, Cole Feinauer, we're back. Spell? Pharaoh.
Pharaoh. P-H-A-R-O-H. Pharaoh.
Incorrect. Nick DiDomizio. Spell? Maneuver.
Maneuver. M-A-N-O-U-V-E-R.
Incorrect. All right, guys, final word. Definitely, this is a group effort. This is not phone a friend.
D-E-F-I-N-I-T-L.
Incorrect.
CHS, thank you so much for having me today. It was so incredible to share some time and some space with each and every one of you. Now, I hope you all took something away with you from today's session. And we talked about kind of three different phases of where we are in life. We talked about the past. Maybe the past hasn't gone exactly as we planned, but we can leverage those obstacles and that adversity and make adversity our advantage. We talked about the present, trying to be absorbed in the present of now, and we touched on the future. And the thing that we know about the future is that everything happens twice, first in our mind and then in reality. My challenge to each and every one of you is to create the future that you see for yourself, for the school, for the community, and for the world. Lean into it, embrace the challenge, enjoy the process. Now, I want to shout out to Peer Health Educators for putting this video together. I'm so excited to see how this whole thing pieces together throughout the day. And for our final acknowledgement and our challenge and our giveaway, my one final question that Coach Lee's got us teed up for, what year did I graduate? What was my graduation year? Please submit that to the question and answer right now. I love you all. I'm a Ram for life. Thank you so much for having me. My very best.
You did great, Julia. Thanks for sticking with us for the entire presentation.
Congratulations to all our winners of the giveaways.
Here's to semester two and the future to come.
Stay safe and remember to wear a mask. Peace and love, CHS.